in all fields. So we have witnessed some cultures in Africa which actually, unfortunately, discriminating against infertile women. We have witnessed that one every four couple is infertile, and 85% of this infertility is coming actually from infections, whether from sexual transmitted diseases, whether from female genital mutilation, whether from unsafe abortion or unsafe delivery. Why is this panel happening? This panel is happening because if we're talking about women empowerment, if we're talking about sustainable development goals, it's about access to healthcare. So this panel is about having access to healthcare. Sustainable development goals is about education. So here this is about awareness and education for women about why this is happening and about prevention. But it's also about changing the mindset and the negative cultural aspects that we are witnessing in our societies. How do we change this mindset? How do we know that a woman is a woman because she's a human being? She has all the rights. It is not related whether she has children or she has no children. But it's also about changing the mindset with reference to the couple. It's a shared responsibility. If we're talking about women empowerment, it is very important that she has access to all the tools of her choice, of the choice of being a mother or not being a mother. So this panel, you have seen that it is really about having all the power of Africa, from the ministers, the academia, the parliamentarians, the private sector. How can we all work together with reference to empowering her socially, empowering her through access to healthcare, empowering her so that no one can come and throw her from her home, no one should come and beat her and she witness violence against her. If we're talking about violence and non-discrimination, which is the convention of elimination of any forms of discrimination against women, we have to say that this is real empowerment. And I am really very happy that this campaign has been led in Africa by my very good friend, Dr. Rasha Kalash, who is the Chief Social Officer of Merck, and also Professor Frank, who is really at the top of the leadership supporting this initiative for women empowerment. So I will give now the floor to Dr. Rasha Kalash.